Welcome to lesson number 4. In this lesson, I will show you how to work with formulas and I will show you the different properties of the different fields. Let's begin. If you remember, when we set up the forms, we set up a number and a decimal field. Let's give them a name. The number will be, let's say, yearly salary, and the decimal will be, for example, bonus. Now, let's assume that I want to calculate both of them. I can drag and drop the formula field. And the formula field will calculate the yearly salary plus my bonus. And when I'm clicking on done, I will click on save. Let's refresh the page. And my yearly salary is 50,000. My bonus is 500. And then the formula is calculating both of the fields. If I'm going back to the formula, you can see that you can update different things about the formula. You can update all the fields basically that we created on the form. We can also do something like rating, which rating is really a number. So we can even play with it. And I can click on the plus button and I'm clicking on rating. And now when I will go to the file, I can have here 50 will be my salary, 50 my bonus. And if I will go all the way to rating, which is 10, you can see that now 110 is the formula, which means I can calculate different things based on number fields. You can also calculate dates, for example. There are lots of things that you can do with the formulas. Most of the people that I know are playing with the formulas only for number calculations, but it's really up to you what you want to do with it. You just click on edit, and then based on the fields, you can do different calculations. Next, I want to show you the different properties for different fields. Let's start with the single line. So let's call this the single line company name, and you can see that I have here a way to lay out the field, small, medium, and large, and that will be how the field going to be presented for us. I can also set an initial value if I want, and let's say the initial value will be comp, okay? And then whenever someone refresh the page, you will see comp as the default value. Let's remove that. You can have the range of how many characters will be in the comp in the company field. And I can say that the minimum is, let's say, 10 and the maximum will be 50. And then when I'm trying, let's refresh the page. When I'm trying to have here more than 50 characters, okay, I will get an error that I can have maximum of 50 characters. Let's go with 0 and 255. I can also say that the field will be mandatory, which means if someone will reload the page, you will see that the field is mandatory with the star beside it. If I will want to click next, you can see that the system will not let me continue without filling this form. Next, I can say that I don't allow duplicates, which means in this file, in this page, I'm not allowing to have the same value. I can also click on hide, which means this field will be hidden and you will not see it. Now you can also ask me, why do we need this option? Because we want the client to see the information in order to fill it. But in some cases, I can have this field. Let me just unhide this field. And let's duplicate it. And I'm clicking here on the green button and I'm duplicating this field. And let's say that I will change it to lead source, which means where the lead came from. And the lead will be website. And I will make it now an hidden field. That means this, the field will be lead source. By default, there is an initial value of website. And whenever I will send this information to my CRM, I will know that the lead source for this specific lead came from my website. Is it making sense? This is why we need the hide option. Another option will be disable field. Let's also duplicate that. And I will have here, let's say, client name, and I will have initial value, and I will click on disable field. Let me show you how it looks like, and I will also tell you why we need it. As you can see here, I cannot change anything. I just see Lior Izik, but I'm not able to make any changes. The reason is that in some cases, I will preload information from my CRM and I will push it into the Zoho form. And I don't want my client to make changes to it. I just want him to see the information without the ability to change it. This is why we have the disable field. Now, you have here some privacy fields and you can encrypt the field when it's being stored, or you can mark it as personal. You have different ways that you can play with it in terms of privacy. You can also input the information using barcode or using QR codes, and that will be using the camera on your phone, okay? So that's also something that you can do. Let me just remove that. Okay, now, all the text related will have the same properties, the same way that I just showed you. The numbers will be a bit different. The numbers will have basically digits instead of characters. They will also have the same things like the string, like the single line. Okay, you can see that everything is almost the same. The two differences that I see in the numbers, decimal or number or currency, it will be that you have digits and also you can write allow negative values. For example, when I will go to the yearly salary and I will have a negative number, you can see that the system is not allowing me to have negative numbers. But if I will go to the new field that I just entered, you can see that I can have here a negative number, no problem. It's because I allowed negative values for this specific field. Now, if we go to email, all of them are the same, basically. You have your different options to allow specific domains for the email or all domains. Not too many people are really using those options. Usually people just want to get the information. So I don't want to overwhelm you with too much information. But I think what I told you so far is really what you need to know. If you're going to the drop-down radio, checkbox, multi options, you will have here a way, and that's very convenient. You will have here a way to import values. Let's assume that I have, let's do countries list CSV. Let's download a list. Okay, so let's say I'm copying this list of all the countries in the world. And now I will go to my form. And I will click here on advanced. I will click here on import. And you can see that I can just type all of them. I'm just pasting. I click on Add Choices. Now I will remove those three options that were given to me as out of the box, and I will click on Save. I will change the name to country. You can see that I have here the countries and I can select the country. Okay, so that's really the way to import. You click on import and you can import based on copy paste to this list, or you have pre-filled information from different common lists that Zoho providing you is out of the box. Okay, so you can just select that, click add choices, and it will be added to your list. That's it. That was lesson number 4. I showed you the different ways on how to manage different fields. And in the next lesson, we're going to play with the form rules. I will show you how to play with different conditions. Very cool. I will see you in lesson number 5.